Okay, so that's the five why is. Then we have the last tool, which is called the five S. Okay, this is a perfect tool which is used for standardization. If we find there's a lot of waste in the process, we try and standardize it by getting to a level where we are able to reduce a lot of non-value added activities, wherein we would be able to give value to our customers and value to the organization as well. So these five S are set in order, sort, shine, standardize, and sustain. So this is not to be used only during the project, but there are people who are in audits, people who are in compliance. These people are very much, very, very near to the 5S, wherein they have to ensure all these things, which helps them to identify some non-valued activities. So let's cover them one by one, and we'll take one example also. So first one is set in order. So for example, if there is any process wherein we find that there are lot many files, lot many products are being there, lot many equipments are there, lot many parts are there, but all of them are scattered. There is no particular place to put that particular equipment. So likewise in a house, when we see that there are too many things scattered here and there, okay? So first step is to set in order, wherein we have to ensure that each activity has to be at the right point in right place. Like in our almirahs or like in our cupboards, we go for, ensuring that each place has to be there at right point in time. That is set in order. Wherein we not only set in order, wherein we also try and removing the waste also, the thing which are not required. And as per the standard, anything which is not required, which was not required for last 1 year, you will not require ever. Okay. So with the help of that, you'd be able to eliminate that unnecessary things which are there in your process. The next is the sort. So wherein you have to sort. So likewise, when you go to any pharmacist or any chemist, you would find that all the medicines are being sorted alphabetically. So when you go to them, they don't take a lot of time. They'll be able to sort it. They'll be able to find it out because they have already sorted it. So sorting it, all the things, so that you'd be able to find out where that thing is placed. Then it's shine. You have to ensure that those things are being, ensuring that those things are being looked at. You can label it. You can make it more visualized so that people would be able to clearly identify what this is all about. Likewise, you see in workplaces, you would see there are visual management when it is mentioned that this is a pantry, this is a meeting room. So that's a shine. Standardizing is that we are monitoring and auditing and, preparing the report that how these things are being prepared. It's a standardization happening to ensure that these things are being prepared, done at a regular interval. And the last is the sustain, wherein we are sustaining all these four and during the regular period of time. That's what is the sustain, which is the 5S, which we usually talk about. So you can use this in your project wherein you find there's a lot of non-value added activities. And with the help of that, you'd be able to move to a certain level also for any of the projects that you're doing. So it is not a mandate, but yes, if you find that there is an opportunity to do a 5S, go for it. Anybody has any questions on the 5S? So with the help of that, we have completed our training, the Lean Six Sigma Black Belt training, that the topic which we're supposed to cover. So we have one thing which is left, which is the design of experiment for more than two levels that I'll cover later. But I want this half an hour to be for any question, any doubts that we have, so that we can cover that one by one.
So Simpreet, you said that we will look into these concepts with some example. Like, will you do that now?
Yeah. So the perfect example could be talking about 5S, right?
Yeah.
So for 5S, the perfect example, I shared it while I was telling it, that in an organization, when you see that the things are cluttered, the things are not at a proper place. So because there's a lot of paperwork, there's a lot of files which are being prepared, a lot of things which are not in place. Okay. So first of all, I would like to do the first step, which is set in order, wherein I would do a discussion with the team and try to eliminate all those things which are not required. First of all, I will eliminate that, those things. So if there are any files, if there are any papers, if there are any systems, anything which are part of my process, any tangible or intangible things, okay? It could be for your systems, it could be for your workplace. So that is something which you will be able to eliminate. Sort is that once you have eliminated it, you have to sort it to ensure that each of the place, each of the things are in place, so that tomorrow, if you want to look for that particular thing, maybe there are different paperwork, so there are different files which are being placed, you'd be able to segregate it. You don't have to look for too many people. You yourself would be able to look at it. Okay, so that is sort. Shine is to give a more label towards it, to clearly articulate what it's talk about, to ensure that it is clearly visible to all of you. It should give an explanation of what this is all about. Okay, so that is shine. Standardize is that this activity has to be done parallelly, not only once or twice. This has to be done at a regular interval. So that is a standardization that I have to do it. I have to monitor it out for some time. And sustain is that I should do set in order, sort, shine, and standardize regularly to see if there's any instability or insanitization which I have come across. I should be able to get rid of it. So every 3 months or 6 months, we should sustain it as well. So that is the quick example that I can think of for doing the 5S.
Sure, thank you.
Not a problem. So now I would want people to ask questions of what has been covered today or during the trainings, and I will try to answer that one.
Simar, are you also going to talk about this Muda, Mudi, and Muri, this thing, because that's a long forgotten.
So that is Muda, Mura, Muri is also types of waste that we have, but generally we focus towards the different types of waste that we covered, which is Timwoods.
Timwoods, okay.
Yeah, so if we focus on the Timwoods, we would be able to identify a lot of waste. So Muda, Mura, and Muri are the Japanese term for the waste only. But yes, we will not be covering Muda, Mura, and Muri.
Sure.
But I want people to ask questions on the topics that we covered on the define till control. We'll see if we can cover all of them today. If not, then we can cover in the doubt session also. But yes, since we have time left, so I would want people to ask questions. Any question which we covered.
Simran, is there any difference between potential causes and potential root causes? Because while I was doing the mock test, there was a question in which potential causes and potential root causes was also there, and only one of them was right answer.
Okay, I'm just making a note of the questions and I will answer them. More questions, please.
So Simar, in the mock test itself, there is a question which is on the sample size.
Yeah,
it is the example given is it's asking to calculate a sample size at a 95% confidence, 5% margin of error, and a standard deviation of 15. Mm-hmm. And it says that why is the car mileage? Mm-hmm. And it does not have a volume or anything defined.
It has everything, but it has not the population.
Yeah, it does not have the population.
And there's one more which is exactly like that. So 95% confidence interval, 5% margin of errors, where we are trying to identify how much percent of people have passed the exam when the historical evidence is 65% of them have passed the exam.
There is no population mentioned in the...
No, there is no population mentioned in both these questions, Simar.
Okay. More questions?
Okay.
So don't think from the sample size, sample paper only, but yes, there must be many questions also which you might have.
There's this one question, Simar. It talks about a sampling methodology while you're creating a X bar R or a X bar S chart. So it has multiple options like the stratified random sampling, the rational subgrouping. But we haven't, I believe we haven't covered that while we discussed it.
Which sampling? Stratified sampling, you said?
Yeah. So the question is, what is the sampling methodology used while creating a X bar R or a X bar S chart? So it's either a quota sampling, random sampling, stratified random sampling, or rational subgrouping. There's a question that I have on, obviously the CPK can be calculated. It talks about ZST and ZLT. So what is given, similar is the LSL is given, the USL is given, the X bar is 10.52. So when you say X bar, we will consider that as a mean, right? When somebody is giving you an option of X bar is 10.52, is that the mean?
Yes, the X bar would be the mean.
Yeah, because then if and the standard deviation is given, CPK can be calculated. None of the options obviously meet with that CPK. That is one. But ZST and ZLT is something that I was not able to understand.
Also, Simar, there was a question regarding calculating yield, but it was what was given was the LSL, USL, and Simar dropped off.
Right, Simar dropped.
Okay, let's wait for him.
Sorry, I got disconnected. Am I audible?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, Simar.
So yes, just yes. So you were saying CPK, ZST, and ZLT.